Alright, let's do this. What's quaking, people? Count Richter Quake here, coming at you with a little more Pokemon Emerald Randomizer Soul Link. I'm here with...
Bernie Stella.
And last episode, we kind of just moseyed along. We went through this weird trick house and got a rare candy. Even though Stella was like, it's just a rare candy. And I was like, well, I want to see if it's randomized. And it wasn't, so I wasted everyone's time. But that's fine. We got some experience. I got a blue flute, which I don't care about. But let's do a little party recap. Anything else story-wise happened last episode besides just getting more encounters and talking to Scott?
We meet Birch, I guess.
Yeah, Birch gave us his number, which is cool. Anyway, let's get a little party recap. Who are we starting with? The starters? All right, we got Cho-Cho the Butterfree, who's not paired with Brock the Machoke, but with Elm the Weeping Bell, who just evolved last episode.
Yep.
We also have Old Fist Relicanth, who's paired with Yakushi the Blissey. We have Kid the Magneton, who's paired with Naruto the Vulpix. And Emily the Gengar, who is paired with Rock the Machoke. So cool. Oh, by the way, check Weeping Bell's ability.
Oh, yeah.
Your abilities change in this randomizer.
Rough Skin. Ooh.
Rough Skin. There you go. Don't, hopefully you're not going to try and use Weeping Bell to catch Pokemon. Because
That's the only Pokemon I have for catching Pokemon, though. That's
well, hopefully it stays asleep and doesn't pincer. This is not a new route, though, right?
No, I don't think so. No, it's not.
Okay. We already got the counter here. Although, pincer, man.
Oh.
Couldn't use pincer because of Cho-Cho, but...
Yeah, Kakuna.
Kakuna, Kakuna. Run away. Stop looking at me.
Oh my god. Oh, Makargo!
Makargo! Akainu, I miss you. I hated you at first, and then I liked you, and then I lost you.
Yes.
That's how it always goes with Pokemon I don't want. I don't want this Pokemon that I use, like, oh, but I love it now.
No!
You can't avoid anybody.
I found some cool Pokemon in the grass around here.
Did you? What is it?
And he shows
Tyranitar.
Oh my god.
Why couldn't I find a Tyranitar?
Later on, okay. That's a cool poke.
I'm gonna hypnotize you. Did Emily... Alright, I had a girlfriend in high school named Emily. Emily, if you're watching this, you're not. But this is not named after you. It's named after a My Hero Academia character. So... I forgot it. He's got choice band. Okay.
My
I
only
gotta stop using hypnosis on Emily. It's got a choice band.
Maybe you should not have choice band on Emily. I'm gonna be honest.
Well, the only reason I did that is because it only has one damaging move, and it's physical.
Yeah.
So I was like choice band, but like.
Okay, Naruto, come back out. This Jirachi is kind of scary because rain
water
is
gun
up.
Is weeping because the sun is up, but.
Oh, it uses wish.
Look at that. Dab water gun on a Tyranitar does that much damage because of the freaking sun.
Jeez.
What is happening? Oh, okay. I was like. That weird noise of the sunshine I thought was a healing move of some sort. Tyranitar, don't wake up. Yes! Tyranitar used Sandstorm and got rid of the sun! So my water guns are going to be stronger now. And I'm a rock type, so I won't be hurt by the sandstorm. That was a weird move, kid. See, this is what I mean by incompetent AI. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
That was not the right move to make. Sandstorm was not the right move to make.
Naruto, please hit a single hypnosis. Or not hypnosis, Will-O-Wisp.
Oh, yeah. Well, too late now. You can't Will-O-Wisp now. But you should use a fire type attack. Oh, it's raining.
Yeah, I was using a fire type attack.
My goodness.
Oh, it's just it heals itself. It has rest and flippin' wish.
Yeah, I'm laggy a little bit on my emulator. It's like, every once in a while it's like, clipping. That's fine.
Jirachi woke up. Use Swift. Okay.
Being cool isn't enough to win. That's true. Being cool is not enough to win.
Please. Yes. Finally, it's dead.
That is, was that the alternate last line to the movie Old Yeller?
Well,
finally, it's dead. Is that a dark joke to make?
I don't know.
Oh, do you not know Old Yeller, the movie?
I probably do. I just don't remember.
Kid's dog has a dog he has a great relationship with, and then it gets rabies and has to be shot at the end.
Oh, I've heard about that movie a lot. Yeah. Because it gets referenced so much.
Yeah, it's
in everything.
Super emotional ending.
Like also in Friends, it gets referenced.
Yeah, it's like a iconic story. And I need a heal because my Pokemon are weak. Okay.
Yeah. Runaway, heal, and then...
Yeah, is this a trainer battle?
Didn't you run into...
Wild Crawdon. Yeah, why am I doing this?
Yeah, exactly. I'm so confused. Right. In speedruns, this is the hardest battle.
What? That's weird.
Yeah, power scaling and stuff, whatever.
In speedruns, are people normally level 20 and 21 at this time?
I don't think so.
That's what I mean.
Definitely don't think so.
Alright, let's go ahead and just do this. Alright, Ho, let's do this. That was rude. Who's reading first, you or me?
You.
Hey, Stella. I mean, two names. So this is where you were. Oh, fuck. How's it going? Have you been raising your Pokemon? I'll check for you.
Wait. Okay. Right. Well, I was searching for other Pokemon. My Pokemon grew stronger. So, how about a little battle?
So nice. Brendan's a dick.
Dano!
Uh-oh. Hey, time you need to bait this dude. No. You need to be strategic about this. Choose what it turns into, and then switch to a Pokemon you're super effective against that. So I would say, turn into Blissey, and then go back out to Rock. Okay. Right?
Okay,
Pidgey! Stop using normal types, I want to use Emily.
Time to get hit by Iron Tail, or it misses. No, it uses Minimize, of course. Oh.
Don't gust, my kid.
Oh my god, it's faster than the Rock. Please.
Yeah, the Ditto's not slow.
Yeah, okay, good. Naruto level 21.
Actually, doesn't Ditto copy all the stats of what it turns into?
Not as far as I'm aware. I don't think so,
I'm pretty sure it definitely does. It definitely does.
I know
that's
it doesn't
why you run,
do
that's,
one of
that's
them.
Why you run a choice car.
I think it does do one of them, though. I'm like 90% sure the HP doesn't copy, but I'm not sure about that one.
I think that's totally not true. That's totally not true. I think it just completely mimics the Pokemon, and that's why you run a Choice Scarf on Ditto, because if you Choice Scarf, you are faster because you have the same speed stat, and then you're Choice Scarfed.
Yeah.
That's competitive play. So.
Yeah. Okay.
Thunder Wave.
I'm just
leveling up. Do I need Thunder Wave? Do I need Thunder Wave?
I mean, Thunder Wave is good to have instead of Tackle.
Alright. You convinced me. You're very convincing.
Oh, Porygon, Scaly.
Why you get to fight a bunch of pink Pokemon? Fun fact, you know about the infamous Electric Soldier Pokemon episode. Electric Soldier Porygon, I think it's called?
Oh yeah, the one that caused epilepsy.
Yeah. Well, it didn't give kids epilepsy, it just caused seizures.
Oh, yeah. And, that's what I mean.
Fun fact, that obviously that episode only aired once.
Yeah.
It was never dubbed in English. But ever since then, Porygon and all of his evolutions have never been featured in the anime since.
Yeah. Yeah.
Poor Porygon got punished for the weird animation choices of the studio at the time. All right, go ahead. Two names. You trained without me noticing. What?
We haven't seen each other for so long.
Take this. Unzip. All right, just kidding. Go. What are we waiting for? So.
We get the item finder. Two names.
There's more dialogue.
You've been busy training too, haven't you?
Yep.
I think you deserve a reward. This is from me.
Okay. Why have both of those dialogues sound like we're gonna get something a little something something inside, you know what I mean? Anyway, go ahead. That's an item finder. Use it to root around for items that aren't visible.
Try it out. If there is an item that's not visible, it emits sound.
If it senses something, it emits a sound. Anyway, I'm off to look for new Pokemon.
That bike. Okay, two names. Let's meet again. I know it's a little silly coming from me, but I think you should train a lot harder for the next time. What do you mean?
That is the most, condescending thing she's said to me so far.
Wow.
Brendan's rubbing off on her. Aw, little Nidorina. I caught one of these already.
Oh, yeah. Let's see. Oh, Dawn Fan.
I love Dawn Fan.
Yeah, it's so cool. Anyways, run. Yeah.
She turns into a tire. Dawn Fan. I have weird Pokemon anime facts all day.
Oh, yeah.
Dawn Fan was one of the first Johto Pokemon to be introduced because when the Pokemon movie came out, you know, the Mewtwo Strikes Back?
Yeah.
The trainer that Ash battles in the beginning of the movie during the opening song has a Dawn Fan, and it's before Gold and Silver.
Oh, yeah. You know the Pika Blue thing?
Meryl, yes.
Yeah.
So that's another thing is that earlier in that, like the what's it called? You know, the movies always had like little mini Pokemon stories to go before the movie.
Yeah.
Like, little short. And the one before that movie had Snubbull and Meryl in it.
Yeah.
So these are like the first introductions to these Pokemon. But of course, the very first Johto Pokemon to be introduced in the anime is who? Stella Pop Quiz.
Dawn Fan.
No, before the movie, in the actual anime.
Oh, wait, it's Togepi.
See, that's what most people would say. Most people would be incorrect, though.
Yeah.
Because at the end of episode one, Ash sees a Ho-Oh flying.
Oh,
over the
rainbow. That thing. That's back before it was.
But the very first identified Johto Pokemon was Togepi.
Yeah, exactly. I wouldn't exactly count that, to be fair.
Well, I'm sorry, there was a Ho-Oh on screen in the first episode. I count it entirely.
Yeah.
I entirely count it.
Intentions. I cannot possibly lose. I fell off cycling road.
I'll get over my embarrassment by battling with you.
That's sad. That's just, I feel
you
bad
go to
for
the hospital. Camera up and
Sizzle.
Play-Doh.
And execute.
Ground type. Alright, let's lick this Claydol. Weird sentence to utter, but I shouldn't have stayed in because Camerupt is a fire type.
True.
That's fine.
I'm running out of PP. which is concerning.
It is concerning, I agree with you.
Well, that's the battle gone. I ended up losing.
Emily's level 21. Learn a move. Yes, Nightshade.
Nightshade, ooh.
Still a ghost. Well, actually, Nightshade, I think, does hit normal types because it's a fixed damage. Or am I wrong? I could be wrong. We'll see. I think I'm definitely wrong, actually, now that I think about it. Don't say it like that. Don't say it like you were totally definitely wrong, for sure. You should go, like, be ashamed of yourself and sit in the corner. Why would you say that to me?
I'm still kind of scared of that Camerupt.
Are you? All I do is growling. It's just trying to intimidate me.
I got a black flute.
Oh my goodness. You got a cool edgy flute. I just licked that camera up from head to toe. And then Sonic boomed it to death. Good tag team there, Emily and Kid. Alright.
Oh, I'm getting cold. Oh, it's Pansy.
Hey, Pansy, what's up?
I challenged someone else after we battled. I came close, but I ended up losing. Oh, well. Wow, that's like really bad Twitter accounts. And I don't even use Twitter.
I use Twitter. You're a content creator. You should use Twitter. It's a good tool for you. Listen, I don't like Twitter either, but I have to use it.
I'm putting element in front.
This pincer's like, please catch me. I can't, pincer. I'm doing a lock.
Oh, I got a soothe bell. In this
pack. I have one of those too.
Yeah, I think I have two.
Why can't I escape from this pincer? Why can't I have to kill this? I have to literally waste time killing this pincer because I can't escape from it.
Ah.
Is it because it used Bind? No, because I tried to run away from the first move and let me.
Nana berries. Wait, is that
what
old
in the world?
Man gonna battle me? I don't think so.
Famous last words.
I mean, he's moving around freely, unlike any trainer.
Oh, you're right. He's not fixed. Which makes him sound like a dog now that I say it out loud.
The two roads, one above, one below. A road each for the people and Pokemon. Perhaps that is right and fair. Okay. Ooh, hello, fisherman.
Fisherman's wharf.
Look, I assume any fisherman has six Magikarps. Yeah.
Well, sometimes you're right. Sometimes you're not right.
Yeah, I think we should go out.
We need to get a bike to Smallville before we go to the cycling road, right?
Oh, yeah.
Smallville City.
Oh. Wait, can I get there?
Why are you so long-winded, little boy? Ellie, how everyone's talking about bikes are so cool.
Wow.
It's like the game telegraphing that I'm going to get a bike in a minute.
Yep.
Ooh, item. Paralyzed heal.
You have to go. Sacred Ash. Wow, that's very useful.
Alright. Oh, I can sell my pearl. Only $700? Oh, I'm gonna sell my rare candy too. Just to piss you off.
Yeah. True.
Watch. I want you to watch my screen while I do this.
Nah.
Just sold the rare candy again. How's it make you feel?
Makes me think you're not smart.
That makes no sense because I need money more than I need to rare candy in this game.
Okay.
You know what this game doesn't have? This game doesn't have area evolutions.
Oh, yeah.
I just got HM6.
Wait, which house is that?
If there were location evolutions, then yeah. I keep real candies. Next to the mart, the one to the right of the mart. You get.
Yeah. I'm pretty sure we are gonna, fight Team Aqua soon. Or wait, since it's Emerald, it's Team... Okay.
Alright, I'm teaching Rock Smash to Emily.
Alright. I mean, yeah, attacking move. Let's see, who can learn it? It's only Rock. Never mind, it's Yakushi as well, and Yakushi kinda needs it. Because they only
Whoa. You need to come get the bike. Well, what an energetic customer.
Whoa, I wanna die. Oh my god! You know what, I give up. I'm gonna do it later.
Wow, that was funny.
Oh, God.
Right.
Well, what have we here? The most energetic. Okay, you did the voice.
You may call me Rydell. I'm the owner of this cycle shop. Your running shoes, yada, yada, yada. They're awfully filthy, huh? Did you come from far away? Saying that you came all the way from Little Root. My goodness, that's ridiculously far. If you had one of these bikes, you could go anywhere easily while feeling the gentle caress of the wind and all that nonsense, you know? I'll tell you what, I'll give you a bike. Feeling generous today. Oh, wait a second. I got to tell you that there are two kinds of bikes. There's the Mach bike, there's the Acro bike. Mach bike is for cyclists who want to feel the wind in their body. That's a weird way to say that, but I did it, bada bing. And an acro bike is for those who prefer technical rides. I'm a real sweetheart, so you can have whichever one you like. Which one will you choose? I want acro.
I'm going Mach.
Alright. Obtain the bike. You get the urge to switch bikes, just come and see me. In Oris, you can get both, can't you? You have to do something, but you can end up getting both.
I don't know.
I'm 90% sure you can get both.
I didn't play that game far enough, I probably.
I've played that more than I've played these, like the original. Oh. Okay, let me look at, Mobile City, and this is... Route 118. I'm pretty sure there's water up here we can get an encounter in. You wanna try? We have to battle first.
Oh, there is 117 here. Okay.
Okay, so I say, are you, what time is it? Yeah, we got time. Battle.
All right.
Battle and encounter.
Let's do this.
The aroma of flowers has a magical power. It cleanses its body and soul.
Go, go, go! Pokemon 1, 2, and 3! Voice acting is my passion. Dr. Mike! Let's go, shout out to Dr. Mike!
Dr. Mike! I love Dr. Mike!
Same, and Trinity.
Alright.
Golem and Armaldo, okay.
Oh, I got Crobat and Hariyama. I love Crobat. This Hariyama will wreck both my Pokemans, though. So I need to be big brain and switch out to Emily. Switching and then be big. You know what? But no, I'm going to trust Kid. No, I'm not going to do that. That's a weird thing to say I'm going to do. I'm going to go to Cho-Cho. Not doing that.
Oh, they have a full 16, though.
What?
Yeah.
Aaron oh, 3 and 3, okay.
Yeah, exactly. Arm drive.
Ooh. That would have done a lot of damage to Kid. Who put the sun up? Will Nightshade do more damage? Nice, good job. You guys realize Nightshade doesn't get boosted by Choice Band because it's fixed damage? So I should have just used Lick.
Yeah. Yeah.
Aw, Lilip.
Lilip.
Kind of miss Boss Chaos.
Oh, yeah. I also miss Alucard.
Alucard. It's weird that you miss Alucard.
Yeah.
Considering you didn't want Alucard.
Yeah. Look, he never got to be a Charizard, so I'm fine with it.
Did not, you're right. Bye, Crobat. Bullfish grew level 21. Oh, yeah. Five more Pokemon.
Ooh, Gyarados.
Gyarados? Gyarados has Thrash.
Yeah. Right.
Five Arm Thrust? Is that overkill, Hariyama? I'm gonna kill you now. I think what I could do is I'm actually going to switch out into Kid and then kill the Hariyama. That way I can Thundershock Gyarados and like just...
I got Dr. Mike on my Pokemon app.
What? I'm jealous. I'm so jealous. Oh, I'll hit one top. Thrash.
Oh.
Yeah, my emulator keeps on like glitching a little bit. I wonder how obvious that'll be in the recording.
I mean, I don't notice it, but also I'm watching from... Yeah.
But the audio glitches out too, which...
Yeah, whenever the emulator lags, the audio lags with it.
Makes it more apparent, you know?
Yeah. I mean, my one is also lagging, but that's every single episode. It's just not... you know.
Yeah.
Anyways.
Rolling Kick. No!
Oh, God.
Oh, that made my... That... Oh, I might have... I might need to change my pants now. Okay. Oh, I'm gonna bait that Rolling Kick out. And, you know what? Just to be safe. Just to be safe. You know what? No, not to be safe. I'm gonna kill this freaking Hitmontop. There we go. Boom. Good job, Cho-Cho.
Cho-Cho gets hit by the Delibird, right? If it has a Icy Wind.
I think it has Present.
Yeah.
It's the only move it has, I think. Which, Emily's immune to. Fucking normal fighting types, man.
Present, yeah.
Thank you. Oh. Got healed.
Good RNG.
Yes. Alright.
Okay, so Cho-Cho on Breloom.
Yeah. Damn, that was powerful.
Yeah.
Alright, bye, Breloom.
Yeah, four times effective.
Whenever I do like a normal Gen 3 run, I almost always have a Breloom on my team.
Yeah, Breloom's cool.
Damn. Delibird is so generous.
Yeah. Since you're... since a lot of your relatives are Czech, do you know what we have instead of Santa on Christmas?
I vaguely remember, but I don't remember what he's called.
Yeah, it's literally little baby Jesus.
Oh no, then I was thinking of an okay. I was thinking.
Oh yeah, for Slovakia, it's Mikuláš.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking of.
Yeah, for Slovakia, it's Mikuláš, but like they're so interconnected even after they split that like.
Yeah.
That was a battle.
Definitely a battle. That was quite the battle. It was a bit nerve-wracking. Who wants my number?
Oh,
Entrepreneur Liliana.
Hello, still, it's Pansy again. Let's go.
Dude, you guys want to go on a date or something? It's like blatant obsession here.
He's a boy, okay?
Right. Yeah, well, way to crush his dreams. All right, let's go ahead and let's go ahead and do this encounter. You first.
Okay.
End off the episode with an encounter. Maybe it's a Pokemon pair we can use. Fingers crossed. Oh, a bite. Alright.
Meowth. So we can't.
Meow. Well, depends on how good this one is that it's paired with.
I mean,
is Meowth.
I have a Blissey.
Blissey's better than Meowth. Oh, that's dupes for me.
Oh. Oh, yeah.
I have to sit here and, hang on, what rod is this?
118. And 117 is to the left.
Let's check something real quick.
Caught the meow. Meowth would draw their sharp claws into their paws to silently sneak about. For some reason, this Pokemon loves shiny coins that glitter with light.
So there are two Pokemon I can get in this water.
Okay. Meowth. I'm gonna name it after my friend's cat that he doesn't have anymore.
Aw, poor cat.
Well, it's a different owner now. Missy.
So the cat's fine, just with someone else now?
Yeah.
Alright, that's... You buried the lead on that story. You made it seem like the cat died.
Ninkata!
Hi!
Hello?
Damn! I don't know why I did that. But yeah, Ninkata!
Time to definitely prank. Can...
Ninkata, hi! I can't attack you in level 6. I like Ninkata. I'm gonna put you in a premier ball. Oh, Ninkata. Poor Ninkata. I guess I have to go out to Cho-Cho and put you to sleep, Ninkata. This Pokemon's also going to be named after an anime character.
Whoa.
Can you guess which anime character I'm going to name it after? You wouldn't know because you don't watch anime because you're not cool.
I have watched some, okay?
Well, it's a character from the anime that you named your Vulpix after, so...
Oh. Oh, I would have to think. My brain. I watched Naruto twice and still don't remember half the things.
So the reason I'm going to name it what I'm going to name it is because of Ninjask and not Ninkata. Let's put it that way.
Okay.
Because it's Ninjask is kind of the ninja, right?
Yeah. I mean, that's its namesake.
Right. And it's a bug.
I had a few in mind, but my brain just can't remember names.
So it's a ninja bug. Whatever could I name a ninja bug? It makes its nest at the roots of a mighty tree. Using its whisker-like antennae, it probes its surroundings in the pitch-black darkness of soil. Why'd I read it like that? I have no idea. All right. So it's a ninja bug. So I always name them Shino.
Okay, yeah, that makes sense. Yeah. Fair enough.
Alright, well, I think we're good right there. Guys, if you enjoyed this episode, like, comment, subscribe if you feel so inclined. Follow me on my social media, join my Discord, follow me on Twitch. Go down below, find the link, and also subscribe to Birdie Stella if you haven't. Till next time, guys. I've been Count Richard Quake, and I've been here with
Birdie Stella.
And we both hope you have a seismic day.
Have a nice day as well.
Seismic is nice.